If you're using a multi-effects unit like this, you should seriously be considering using a speaker system like this. Today I'm going to be telling you all about the FR-FR systems and how they can make your multi-effects unit shine. Stay tuned. Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Addicted to Gear. My name is Tony. Thank you for joining me once again. Today, we're going to be doing a lesson on FR-FR speaker systems and why they are essential if you're using any kind of multi-effects unit in your gig arsenal. So, if you're using a multi-effects unit like I am from time to time, you will understand very quickly that the biggest challenge with using something like this is getting the sound to reproduce the way you hear it in your headphones when you're programming the thing in a live situation. Now, multi-effects units are great because they really do allow you to have a real large palette of sounds available at your disposal if you're playing in a gigging band, a cover band, where you need a lot of different sounds throughout the night. Not only is it affordable, it's also very convenient and easy to carry. So it's an ideal solution. But the frustrations that most guitarists live with these multi-effects unit start happening when they try and reproduce the sounds that they worked so hard in creating in their studio in a live situation or a live venue. And today we're going to be talking about the virtues of using FR-FR systems in a situation like this. So this little beast is a Headrush 2000 watt FR-FR speaker cabinet. Now, for those of you that are not familiar with FR-FR systems, you're probably wondering, what exactly is that? Well, an FR-FR system is basically a cabinet and speaker with an integrated power supply that has been designed specifically to give you flat response and full frequencies so that you have the truest sound reproduction without any sound coloration that comes out of it while you're playing the sounds that you programmed into your multi-effects unit. Now, a lot of you are going to ask me, well, can't I just plug in my multi-effects unit into my combo amp or into my guitar cabinet? You can, but the problem with that is that your guitar cabinet is tuned to certain frequencies that you don't necessarily want when you're using a multi-effects unit, because it will color the original sounds that you intended to hear when you were programming it. And all speaker cabinets have a certain degree of coloration due to the cabinet size, the cabinet construction, as well as the speakers that are being used in the cabinet. Most guitar speakers are not designed to be flat frequencies or full response. They're really designed to tailor the sound in those mid frequencies that make a guitar sound good. So although a 4x12 cabinet like the one behind me sounds awesome when you're playing it through a Friedman head or a Marshall head, they don't necessarily sound that great when you're using them to pump the sound through from your multi-effects unit. These cabinets are basically designed to do a couple of things really well. First of all, they're portable, they're not that heavy, they have a lot of power. This particular unit has about 2000 watts peak. Now, don't confuse peak power with the same kind of power rating that you would think about when you're talking about, say, a Marshall head. That's not peak. Peak means it can handle extreme high volume and wattage for a short amount of time without blowing. So a small cabinet like this that basically has a 1/8-inch speaker has the ability to really pump out a lot of sound. So many of you I know are thinking, well, what's the difference between this type of speaker and say a PA speaker? Because they kind of look a lot like one another, don't they? Well, they actually do, but they're designed for different things, different applications. A PA speaker is really designed to have all of the sound coming through it sound good, whether it's a guitar, a voice, a piano, a saxophone, or a keyboard, and really to make everything sound really good. This particular type of speaker is really designed to make everything sound as flat and as true as possible. So it doesn't really focus on any one of the frequency spectrums. It really is designed to be flat. Now, the added advantage to using something like this is that you do have some flexibility. First of all, you have two different inputs in the back of it that you can plug in from your multi-effects unit, or say a microphone or something like that. And they also have a balanced output that you can actually take from the speaker and go into the front of house or maybe into your recording gear. That is very, very handy. You also have two volume controls, so you can decide how much headroom you want to have coming through the unit from your multi-effects unit. And you also have a little contour switch here in the back that gives you the ability to either give it almost like a fuller sound, almost like a little loudness switch on your stereo system. And also, it's designed for portability. As I mentioned, it's quite small. It's got really nice handles so you can lift it and move it. It even has a mounted mount location here, so you can actually mount it on a pole and have it way up high, where you can actually use it as a monitor or a wedge. You can place it flat, or you can place it pointing towards you, depending on how you like your sound. The other cool thing about these FR systems is that they're relatively small. So this one that has only an 8-inch speaker in it is not extremely heavy or large, so you can actually take it with you quite easily and not have to worry about carrying too much weight. The other thing you can do is you can actually use two of these in stereo, so that at that point you're basically pumping stereo sound. You can play with ping pong delays. You can do a whole bunch of like spectrum spreading sounds a la David Gilmour or something like that, and really be able to get a really large sound without having too much gear. You really just have two of these, put them on the floor, one on one side, one on the other side, and you're pretty much ready to go. Now, what if you wanna have one of these cool speaker systems and use it with your multi-effects unit, but at the same time, you wanna maybe record your sound? Can you record using a microphone and one of these speakers? Well, technically you can, although it's a little bit tricky because of a couple of things that I'm gonna make you aware of right now. First of all, this particular unit has a really solid grill that protects the speaker that's inside of it. But beyond the grill, there's another foam piece just on the underside of this grill that basically blacks out everything. You can't really tell where the speaker location is. Is it up here? Is it down here? And the fact that it's a full frequency flat response system, it really means that it's using a woofer. It's usually using a tweeter, and it probably has a port as well, like a bass port. So where you point your microphone is extremely important, and it's really hard to see. Even if you try and shine a flashlight in here, you can't really tell where it is. So that's a little disadvantage. The other thing is you really want to get all of the sound, and miking this type of speaker is not exactly the same as miking a guitar cabinet, because a guitar cabinet is relatively simple. It's one speaker cone that you got to mic using, you know, pointing the mic right to the center of the speaker cone or moving it slightly off center or whatever. That's enough to get all of the nuances of that particular speaker. But because this is a full frequency speaker, it's kind of like the same idea of trying to mic your hi-fi speakers, for example. You could mic the woofer, but then you're going to be missing all the highs. If you focus towards the tweeter, then you're going to be getting all of the highs and none of the low end. So it's a little bit more complicated and not always that easy. That's why a lot of YouTubers don't really use these to give you the sound that they're trying to demo, unless they're using room mics and a couple of little sophisticated miking tricks. So one word of advice I have for you guys, if you're considering going for one of these FR systems, then don't underestimate the power coming out of these things. They're very loud and they have a ton of bottom end. Now, when I was looking at purchasing one of these units, I considered going with a unit that had a 12-inch speaker in it. This one only has an 8-inch speaker in it, which is considerably smaller. But to be honest with you, this unit has a ton of low end. I'm really glad I didn't go for the 12-inch because it would have been way too much. I've actually compared this with my cabinet here for my Marshall 412, and this thing could easily drown out the 412 cabinet in terms of bass alone. So it really, really has a lot of punch and it really fills out the sound spectrum without any doubt. So if you're considering it and you think it might not be enough, trust me, it will be enough. And I'm glad I went with the smaller one because of the portability aspect, because the larger speaker would have also meant a bigger unit and it would be a little bit more complicated to lug around. Now, although I decided to go with the Headrush unit, there's a lot of other companies offering these type of speakers, lower end and higher end. And really the prices start at a couple of hundred dollars all the way to a couple of thousand dollars, depending on what you're looking for. Now, they all have different features and they're all slightly different in terms of what they offer. But, you know, this is kind of like the entry level that you can get, but it's really good. So far, I haven't had any issues with it. I really like it. I will do a full review on this particular unit, talking about this particular model and specifically, but I wanted to give you a rundown of what an FR-FR system is, because a lot of people really did not understand why they would need it and why they couldn't just go into a regular guitar cabinet. Now, the cool thing is that some companies that are making these systems are actually making them so that they actually look like guitar cabinets and you can't really tell the difference when they're on stage. And that's a cool thing. I also think that those particular units may be a little bit more durable because they do have an actual wood chassis around it so that they can withstand the wear and tear of gigging, while this is really just a plastic enclosure, which is a little bit more fragile. You have to be a little bit more careful with it. So depending on what kind of, you know, wear and tear you need, you can opt for one of the more durable ones. So for those of you interested in checking out the specs on this Headrush unit, I'll put the link down below to the website so you can get more of the technical specs on it and see if it's right for you. But there, I just want to be clear that there's a lot of other companies that you can go with besides Headrush. Friedman makes great units, Mission Engineering, ISP Technologies, Line 6, and the list goes on and on. So really, you want to look at what they offer and see if they're right for you. So next time you're frustrated because you can't really get the sound to reproduce well in the space that you're playing in, and you might get frustrated enough to decide to dump the multi-effects unit and go back to pedals, trust me, I know, I've done it a couple of times, consider checking out an FR-FR speaker system like this with your multi-effects unit. I think you're gonna be pretty happy that you do, because you're gonna really get a lot more consistent sound reproduction and a lot less headaches. And at the end of the day, it's gonna be a lot more fun squeezing out every last note that you've painstakingly programmed into your multi-effects unit. So I hope this quick video on FR-FR systems answered some of your questions. If something wasn't clear enough and you have some other questions for me, please leave your comments down below. I always answer my questions and I'm happy to do so. If you like the content that we're producing and putting out here on Addicted to Gear, please spread the word, give us a thumbs up, that helps our channel tremendously, and consider subscribing if you haven't already done, because we're gonna have a lot more great content for you coming up. That's it for now, guys, so please stay tuned, keep rocking, more great videos to come right here on Addicted to Gear. See you soon.